जय हिंद कैडेट्स एंड वेलकम इन दिस न्यू सेशन बाय डिफेंस करियर एकेडमी। हियर इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न सम इम्पॉर्टेंट मैजिक रूल्स ऑन स्पॉटिंग एरर्स। डियर कैडेट्स, दिस इज पार्ट 4 इन द सीरीज। इन अर्लियर पार्ट्स ऑल्सो यू कैन लर्न सम मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट रूल्स ऑफ स्पॉटिंग एरर्स एंड इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न सम इम्पॉर्टेंट रूल्स, देयर एग्जाम्पल्स एंड सम इम्पॉर्टेंट ट्रिक्स टू सॉल्व द क्वेश्चंस ऑन स्पॉटिंग एरर्स। So without wasting any time, let's continue. This is rule number one. Here we are going to talk about the sequence of tenses. When do we use perfect continuous tense? Perfect continuous tense is used to talk about an action which started or began in the past at a definite or indefinite point of time, an action which started in the past and is still continuing at the time of speaking in present. Okay, for example, we started learning English some years ago, for example 10 years ago, 15 years ago, 5 years ago, something. Means the action of learning started in the past and it is still continuing at the time of speaking in present. This kind of action is known as present perfect continuous action. And for talking about such action, we use the adverbs of time such as since, for, how long, etc. So whenever we are using these words, since, for, how long, it suggests that we are talking about a perfect continuous action, present perfect continuous action. And in this case, we should always use present perfect continuous tense, have been plus ing form of the verb or has been plus ing form of the verb. As you can see in this example, in the first example, which is incorrect, how long are you working in this office? Are you working? Are working is present continuous tense. Am is are plus ing form of the verb. This is incorrect because how long, this phrase indicates that the action started at a definite or indefinite point of time in past and is still continuing at the time of speaking in present. So here the tense needs to be present perfect continuous. That's why the correct answer is how long have you been working in this office. So this is rule number one. Let's go to rule number two. Here in this rule we can see that when a verb is preceded by a preposition, it must always be a gerund. Gerund is nothing but the ing form of a verb when used as a non-finite verb, not as a main verb. Okay, so in the first example you can see they were punished for come late. Here for is a preposition and this preposition is preceded by a verb, means a verb is used after it and preposition is used before it. Okay, preposition precedes this verb and verb follows this preposition. And in this case, when a preposition comes before of a verb, the verb must be a gerund. It cannot be an infinitive, bare infinitive or to infinitive. So the correct sentence will be they were punished for coming late. Here coming is the correct form of the verb when it is preceded by a preposition. Here for is a preposition which precedes this verb. That's why this verb needs to be in the continuous, in the ing form, that means in the gerund form. So this was rule number two. Now let's go to the rule number three. Here in this rule we can see that the future indefinite tense, it means future simple tense, is not used in the clauses of time, place and condition. Whenever we are talking about time, place and condition, for example condition, a clause of condition begins with if, a clause of time begins with when, and a clause of place begins with where. The clauses which begin with when, where and if, in those clauses we need to use present indefinite tense, it means present simple tense. We need not use simple future tense. Here in these cases, in these clauses, present simple tense indicates an immediate future action, especially in the clause of condition. You can see in the first example, I shall wait for you till you will finish your work. Here till is a conjunction which shows time, and the clause which starts from till is a clause of time. That's why There needs to be a present indefinite tense. It means present simple tense. Here, will plus finish is a future indefinite tense, which is incorrect. So the correct tense will be till you finish your work. Okay, I shall wait for you till you finish your work. You'll have to keep in mind that if a clause begins with till, until, when, where, and if, unless, etc. Okay. If these are the conjunctions which introduce clauses, these are the conjunctions of time, place, and condition. So we need to use simple present tense, that is present indefinite tense. That's all about rule number 3. Now let's go to rule number 4. Here in this rule number 4, we can see that the present perfect tense is not used with the adverbs of past time like yesterday. We don't use present perfect tense with the word yesterday, because yesterday shows a past action and present perfect shows an action which is finished at the time of speaking in present time. Okay. We cannot use this tense, present perfect tense, in 1990 like this. Such phrases also cannot be used in present perfect continuous tense. Present perfect tense. Here past indefinite tense is used, means past simple tense is used whenever we are using the words yesterday, in 1990, okay, in the last week, in the last month, etc. You can see the example, I have bought a cycle yesterday. Here have bought is present perfect tense. And with present perfect tense, the rule says that you cannot use the word yesterday, because yesterday shows a past action. You can say, I bought a cycle yesterday. Bought is past indefinite tense. It is past simple tense, which is appropriate with the word yesterday. And the present perfect tense, have plus V3, cannot be used with the word past yesterday or in 1990 yesterday, etc. So this is rule number 4. Now let's go to rule number 5. Rule number 5 is talking about modal auxiliaries. We don't use modal auxiliaries together, but two auxiliaries can be connected by a conjunction. Okay. For example, here in this sentence, he should and must do it. Should is a modal auxiliary. Must is also a modal auxiliary. We cannot use them one after the other. We can separate them using a conjunction, and, but, etc., whatever it is. Okay, you can also use as well as. He should and must do it. This is now appropriate use. And simply you just have to keep in mind that two modal auxiliaries do not come one after the other without a conjunction. Now let's go to rule number 6. In rule number 6, we will talk about auxiliaries and bare infinitives. Okay. When need or dare is followed by not, when we say need not, when we say dare not, okay, these are modal auxiliaries. When we use them in negative sense, it turns into modal auxiliary. Then in that situation, it takes bare infinitive. After the verb need, if we use not, it takes bare infinitive. And we cannot use needs not or dares not. Okay, we do not add s or es to this verb when not is used with it. Simply, if we are using the word need or dare, we can convert them into the s form. Means we can add the suffix s or es in the end when we are talking about a third person singular subject. Here in this example, you can see he needs not do it. This is incorrect, even though the subject, he is third person singular subject. Because need not is a modal auxiliary and we don't use s with it, although the subject is third person singular. Because modal auxiliaries don't follow this rule, adding s or es to the main verb in simple present tense. And the correct sentence is he need not do it. Okay. So that's all about rule number 6. Now let's go to rule number 7. In rule number 7, we are going to talk about some adjectives. Some adjectives are used with countable nouns and some adjectives are used with uncountable nouns. The adjectives which are adjectives of quantity, such as they are also known as quantitative adjectives, show how much of a thing is meant. Adjectives of quantity, sum, much, little, enough, all, no, any, great, half, sufficient, whole, etc. These are some of the adjectives of quantity. Here you will have to distinguish adjectives of quantity from adjectives of number, which is also known as adjectives of numerical adjectives. We call them numerical adjectives or adjectives of number. For example, few, many, etc. are adjectives of number. Okay, and here we are not talking about adjectives of number. We are talking about adjectives of quantity. These show how much, not how many. So with these adjectives of quantity, we use uncountable nouns. We don't use countable nouns. Remember this thing. And we don't use adjectives of number with uncountable nouns. Here in the first example, you can see that I ate a few rice. Rice is uncountable noun. Can we count? Can we say one rice? Can we say two rices? Three rices? Can we say one water, two waters, three waters? No, we cannot. That's why these are known as uncountable nouns, and with these uncountable nouns, we cannot use numerical adjectives like a few, many, etc. We cannot say that there are many waters in the tank. We can say that there is much water in the tank. Okay, so some is an adjective of quantity, and this is the right adjective here. I ate some rice. So that's all about rule number 7. Now let's go to rule number 8. In rule number 8, we are going to talk about numerical adjectives. In rule number 7, we talked about quantitative adjectives, adjectives of quantity. See, here numerical adjectives are used for countable nouns. As we discussed in rule number 7, with uncountable nouns, we use quantitative adjectives or adjectives of quantity, but with countable nouns we don't use adjectives of quantity, we use numerical adjectives. Okay, and they show how many persons or things are meant, unlike how much is represented by quantitative adjectives as discussed in rule number 7. Okay, or in what order or person or things stand. Okay, as you can see in this example, I have taught you little things. Instead of little things, we need to use a few things. Okay, little is uncountable, is used with uncountable noun. Things is a countable noun. We can count it, one thing, two things, three things. Okay, so little is not used with a countable noun. Okay, it is used with only uncountable noun. For example, there is little water in the tank. Okay, because water is uncountable noun, we cannot count one water, two waters. Here, a few is the most appropriate adjective. I have taught you a few things. Maine aapko kuch cheeze padhai hai. Okay, that's all about rule number 8. Now let's go to rule number 9. In rule number 9, we are going to talk about cardinals and ordinals. You might have learnt in mathematics 1, 2, 3, 4. These are known as cardinal numbers, and first, second, third, fourth, these are known as ordinal numbers. Okay, and the rule says that when both of the adjectives are used in a sentence, for example, you can see that in sentence number 1, the first four boys, four is a cardinal number, first is an ordinal number, and the rule says that an ordinal number precedes the cardinal number. Okay, before the cardinal number, we need to use an ordinal number. Here you can see that instead of four first, we need to use first four. The first four boys were given the chance. Instead of saying the four first boys, first is an ordinal number, four is a cardinal number. So first precedes four. Ordinal number precedes cardinal number. Means ordinal number cardinal number se pehle use hota hai adjectives mein. So this was the last button rule. Now let's go to rule number 10. This is the last rule in this session. And in this rule, we are going to talk about the position of a few typical words. Later, latest, refer to time. Latter and last refer to position. Okay. Here, later means after some time. And here, latter means the next in position. Okay, It shows position. Latter shows position. For example, we are talking about two different people, Mahesh and Dinesh. Mahesh and Dinesh are my brothers. The first is doing engineering, while the latter means the one whom I mentioned for the second time. Okay, whose position is later. Okay, in position. Okay, for example, Mahesh and Dinesh. I have mentioned Dinesh afterwards. Okay, that's a latter. Here, latter shows the person or the thing which I mentioned afterwards. Okay, and first latter. Pehla, dusra. Okay, Mahesh and Dinesh are my brothers. Pehla hai engineer, dusra hai doctor. Pehla engineering kar raha hai, dusra doctoring kar raha hai. Okay, so Mahesh and Dinesh, the first and the latter. Here latter is used to show position, while later shows time. Later means after some time, and latest also refers to time. Latest means recent in time, something that is recent in time. And last also shows position. For example, he scored the last position in NDA examination or whatever examination. Okay, so there is a lot of confusion among students about these words, latest, later and latter, latest and last. So never get confused about them. Always remember the point that later and latest refer to time, while latter and last refer to position. Okay, in a list, many students are listed, and if your position is last, means it is showing position. Last is showing position. Latest is not showing position. It shows something that is recent in time. Means it shows time in short. Here in this example, you can see I reached at 10 a.m. but he was later than I expected. Means here we are talking about time, and we should not use the word. Here we are talking about time, so we should not use the word latter. We should use the word later. Okay. I reached at 10 a.m. My 10 baje pahuncha, but he was later than I expected. Lekin वो एक्सपेक्टेशन से ज़्यादा लेट आया. ओके, लेटर दैन एक्सपेक्टेड. दैट्स ऑल फॉर नाउ. थैंक्स फॉर वॉचिंग. विजिट अस एट द सोशल प्लेटफॉर्म्स. कॉन्टैक्ट अस एट द गिवन ईमेल आईडी. दिस ईमेल आईडी यू कैन कॉन्टैक्ट अस एट. यू कैन ऑल्सो कॉन्टैक्ट अस एट. ऑल्सो विजिट दिस वेबसाइट फॉर मोर डिटेल्स अबाउट डिफेंस करियर अकेडमी औरंगाबाद. थैंक यू. हैव अ नाइस डे.